Welcome back once more. You're watching KT, you're watching Sunday edition on KTN News. Thank you for joining us this Sunday morning. It is now afternoon. It is 7 minutes past midday. Let's turn our attention to the ongoing fight against corruption. We just did see in the last couple of days, in the last 2 weeks, the Director of Public Prosecutions, Nurdin Haji, crank up the pressure. Ojamong, so Peter Ojamong, the Busia governor, was arrested last week but one. And now we did see the Council of Governors coming out to say or to demand that governors, county bosses, should be granted immunity from prosecution, just the way the head of state enjoys that privilege, cannot be prosecuted while in office. Let's listen in to what the chairman, Josphat Nanok, had to say about this.
So these council governors must come down to earth. They must come down from the ivory tower.
People means, very simply, the power of the people to elect leaders, the power of the people to determine the system of government that they want, and those people whose power has been ceded to must exercise that power with certain boundaries. The argument by Governor Nanok and his other colleagues is completely misplaced, because when I heard him say that, and I quote him, that in other civilized...
Mary Senator Linturi responding to that. Let's now listen into what the chairman of the Council of Governors, the Turkana governor, Josphat Nanok, did say about this demand by the governors. All right, apologize for that technical issue. We shall be looking for that for Josphat Nanok's views. But he did say that this fight against corruption is being politicized, dismissed, saying that the governor should also enjoy immunity from prosecution while in office, just like the president. Do you think this has any sort of... Does he have any points?
You know, Ben, I'm one of those few privileged Kenyans who have the occasion of having coffee with these governors. Mm. And individually, they're very sharp. But I think when they are in a collective position, as Mark Bichach has said, they suspend reasoning, they suspend logic, and they venture into mischief. Number one, they need the benefit of good lawyers. Maybe at this stage, they need to speak to Karori. And if they can't afford Karori's rates, they can actually afford me. And then I can give them free advice. Because if you look at clause 143 of our constitution, the constitution anticipates that a governor can actually be jailed. And if you are jailed for more than 12 months, then the position becomes vacant. So the constitution itself provides for that position, that if you engage in any mischief, you are jailed for more than 12 months, your deputy takes over. And the only person who enjoys immunity in any jurisdiction that they're making reference to is only the head of state. And even for President Kenyatta today, he does not enjoy absolute immunity. Again, if you refer to the Kenyan constitution, there are provisions that say if Kenya has entered into an international treaty and the president is in breach of that, he can be prosecuted. For instance, if the Kenyan president engages in money laundering, he'll find himself in court. This is the same thing which happened to President Kenyatta. He was in office, right, but he was being prosecuted on ICC issues. So for these governors, if they're looking for immunity from prosecution, then let them respect Chapter 6 of our Constitution. Let them run that office with integrity. They shouldn't steal Wanjiku's coin. They should not steal Wafula's coin. They should not steal Mura's coin. If they deliver their mandates without stealing, then that would be the immunity they are looking for. But to have these 47 governors saying they want to be treated like small lords, like small kings, it's absurd. And I see it happening. If you go to the villages, when a governor is moving around, they've got an escort of 10 vehicles. They've got a seat, a special purpose seat. They've got a mobile toilet. Then they've got a BV of sycophants. We shower them with praise. They lie prostrate for them to step on their backs. And they think they can now steal money for 10 solid years as Haji keeps a blind eye. How? The Auditor General, year in, year out, says all these governors are stealing. They're stealing every single day. Right. And if you want to see the way they treat Kenyans as if we are toilet paper to be flushed down a tree, is Ojamong says, why are you accusing me of only 8 million? Mungeniambia ningelipa hii. So for him, he's saying, this 8 million, I can refund it. And the tragedy is that right now people are looking at the 2014, 2013 reports. When we get to reports for last year, you'll be shocked.
Yes.
In fact, according to people knowledgeable in this business, senators at the Senate that Mark Bichache doesn't like, they say the levels of impunity, mediocrity, and corruption will shock Kenyans. That if we pursue the penal code and the economic crimes, all these governors will be behind bars.
All right. Let's listen to Josphat Nanok now and during that statement by the Council of Governors.
The best practice in jurisdictions that are devolved is that the heads of both levels of government have immunity on civil and criminal proceedings while they are in office.
So, Lucy, when Kenyans saw that the live pictures on TV of the Busia governor being taken to Integrity Center, you know, they loved that. They were like, you know what, this fight against corruption is getting serious. But now governors are saying they don't like that. They want immunity. They don't like to be, you know, accountable to Kenyans. What do you think about it?
First of all, I would like to say that governance and immunity is a debate that is supposed to be debated sobriety. Mm-hmm. The reason being, you know, when they are saying that they want to take advantage of that, we are not supporting the president fighting corruption, yeah? Mm-hmm. And if they are clean, they are not supposed to be worried. So to me, I would like to say that apart from, in fact, this, I was thinking that since the constitution is very clear about the immunity,
yes,
we're also supposed to include the deputy president on that, but not the governors.
All right, so you think the deputy president
yes, he's supposed to enjoy that.
Do I get to speak
yes.
after her?
Ben, just a moment, yes. please, so that I don't lose this. The only person in Kenya who enjoys immunity is the president of the Republic of Kenya. The deputy doesn't enjoy. The two speakers yes. do not enjoy it. Cabinet secretaries do not enjoy it.
But Lucy is saying
so where do these governors are coming from? Mm. No way, we can't allow that. Mm. Then in that case, all Kenyans, we need
not
to review
Kenyans.
Our constitution that all Kenyans
not
in the
Kenyans.
Public sector enjoy immunity when
no.
they're serving.
In fact, what I was saying to say is that we can include the deputy president on that immunity thing, eh?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, but not governors and others for servants.
All right.
Yeah.
Jesus, fuck me. A number of things. Dear governors, elected leaders, the only immunity we are going to give you is the immunity of the courts putting you in jail, ndio hiyo funzo kwa wengine kama wewe. The only immunity we are giving you is the ability to go to prison so that you learn not to steal from Kenyans. Number two, do not ever imagine in your heads that you are like a president. Like a president of what? Number one, these governors can't even raise revenues. Number two, they do not even know how to manage a wage bill. Number three, what have they done? In fact, as far as I'm concerned, the only governor who can talk about being worth his salt is the Makueni governor, Professor Kivitha Kibwana. The rest of these people are painting roads in Machakos or filling social media like the Nairobi governor. Number one, even the intelligence of some of these governors is seriously lacking. How can you give immunity to a fool? My friend, you'll be raped, pillaged, and broken into your homes because such people do not deserve the time that we give them. In fact, Ben Kitili, it is a shame that we are using major intellect on this table to discuss nonsense. There is no immunity for no governor. For what? Immunity is only applicable to the head of state because the logic has always been that since he's in charge of You're holding brief for someone. I will not indulge you in that conversation. The head of state is given that role mm-hmm. for the simple reason
right.
that he is in charge of the security agencies of this country, such that if he needs to make a decision that Osama bin Laden was crossing into the border of this country and he ordered for Osama bin Laden to be shot, he requires immunity. That is why that immunity exists. The immunity does not exist for you to rape and pillage the public and come to us that because you are voted for, you deserve
so
to
what
be
they're
given
saying,
immunity.
The Council of Governors, what the governors are saying is that now some people are using this war on corruption to humiliate them and make them not be able to perform their duties and to target them politically.
They're already not performing. You understand? You cannot say someone is stopping you from performing when you're doing nothing. You're already out of the World Cup. You're kicked out with Argentina. Now you're saying that the referees are keeping you from scoring. The reality of the matter, only the wicked, only the guilty run when no one gives a chance. When they're running because they know they're guilty, their hands are in the cookie jars. Right. Look at the number of hotels in every county today that are owned by these governors. Look at the number of hotels they've created so that they can send MCA there so that they can send back their money. Look at the number of benchmarking trips they have gone for. Every year benchmarking, you're going to Israel to benchmark the same thing. If you go to Mombasa today, you go to those hotels, there are two kinds of people you'll meet. There are politicians and tourists.
Right.
You will know them because the skin color
right.
is different.
Kipchumba.
The politicians are there benchmarking and having meetings every time. Why? Because they're being corrupt.
Kipchumba, because of the so-called devolved corruption, is then granting immunity from prosecution to governors, would that be akin to shooting ourselves in the foot as Kenyans?
You know, Mark, at times I Ben Kitili, at times I confuse this country with a very large jokes country. You know, we are a big standard comedy country. The only immunity, and let me tell this to governors who are watching or who will be briefed after this show by their people who are watching, the only immunity we can extend to governors, and I'm speaking as a lawyer, is the immunity for them to lie to us, to do all manner of cantankerous theatrics to us on social media. That is the only immunity we are giving governors. But in terms of legally...
Twitter immunity.
Yes, Twitter, social, Facebook, that is the only immunity we have allowed them to have. But when they land back to this country known as Kenya, let me tell them the facts are there. I want to invite them to read Article 1, and not to read it to what they like reading. They should start with Article 1 of the Constitution and understand what we mean by sovereignty. Sovereignty belongs to the people. All of us are sovereigns. There is nothing like they are protecting sovereignty of counties. From who? Uganda is not interested in Busia, or it doesn't want to take over Uasin Gishu mm-hmm. or Machakos. Which sovereignty are we talking about? Two, we cannot interpret the Constitution to add into an absurdity. Look at it this way. I think we need to have a serious workshop after every election when people win elections before they are sworn in. I invite the governors to go back today and read their oath of office afresh. It is written in the most simple English. It doesn't need a dictionary. It just needs a man who have woken up after a good nap. You just understand. That is where we should begin. Because by reading the oath of office, it addresses most of these issues. Two, I welcome them to read Article 179. Mm-hmm. They are the chief executive officers of the counties they head. They should not talk to us about political responsibility. They are in charge of the funds that are used in those counties. The Mama Mboga who voted during the 99 election did not vote for the CEC. He or she voted for a county governor. Mm-hmm. So we should not go back and forth. And secondly, I think also whoever is advising Nanok as the COG chair is doing him a great disservice and is causing him to be a public laughing stock. Look at it this way. Nigeria is on record of having jailed several governors. Which immunity are they talking about? And how can we give immunity to people who do not seem to understand their key mandate? Mm-hmm. Secondly, when they talk about political witch hunt, who is witch hunting Ojamo? For which gain? These people, most of them are second-term governors. There is nothing they can do after this. They are time-bound by the Constitution. Mm-hmm. Why will you witch hunt them? And that's why I'm saying this. The DCI, the Directorate of Criminal Investigation, the DPP, they should swing in. We should see heads roll. But what we must respect is this. We should just let us arraign the governors or arrest them in a manner that gives them honor as elected leaders. But again, they should not expect honor if they are looting without honor.
All right, so the members of parliament have been speaking about this, the watchdog committees. Let's listen into what they have to say about this.
This council governors must come down to earth. They must come down from the ivory tower in which they are perched and face reality. In fact, they're just joking. Even those who have left office and those who will be leaving office will still be pursued if there are acts of transgression that they have committed.
And we should not allow governors to have any kind of immunity, because they made themselves procurement officers, they made themselves the accounting officers, and they committed the counties beyond what their finances would require them or would allow them to do.
All right, Dismas, let's wrap up this conversation. What are your final thoughts on this?
Two things come to mind. Governor Nanok makes reference to the US, where he says the federal states, or rather the governors, have got immunity. But what he forgets that Bill Clinton, when he was a president of the US, he was accused of having some relationship with Monica Lewinsky, which was unacceptable. And he was taken to task while as president of the United States of America. A special prosecutor was appointed and he was taken to task. So he cannot even start thinking using that example. Then number two, the same Governor Nanok makes an assertion that would make any Kenyan nervous. He says, because of the tribulations around Governor Ojamong, Busia has come to a standstill. What does that tell you about our governors? If you're a governor and you're not able to create systems that can run with or without you, then you are a failure. You don't deserve the honor of being referred to as a governor. You don't deserve that title of His Excellency the Governor. You need to go home. And in any event, we know that for a number of governors, like, for instance, Governor Joe at some stage was in Dubai, and Karori says that there were many selfies. But, you know, Mombasa did not come to an abrupt stop. It was still going. When the governor in Nyeri was indisposed and he was in the UK, Nyeri was still running. A successful governor is the one who creates systems which run with or without him being around. And we know for a fact, there are no documents they sign. We've got public servants who are running the show. So in my view, all these governors, they need to be given a crash program to understand that if they're looking for immunity, it's not immunity from stealing. You cannot be immunized from stealing. That we will give you 10 years to go and plunder the entire county, then we start prosecuting you after on the 11th year. That's unacceptable. Instead of them working and delivering value so that we start celebrating devolution, all that. I mean, can you imagine? You have governors coming all the way from Turkana, Mandera, Kisumu, Kisii to Nairobi, and all they want to ask is give us immunity. How much money did they spend? How much money did they waste to come to Nairobi claiming allowances, per diems, and all this to say they want immunity?
Lucy, unacceptable. Your final thoughts on this. So with such propositions, do you think the governors can fight corruption in their counties?
No, they cannot. And that's why they are requesting for immunity. Yeah, so to me, we selected them to work for us.
Mm-hmm.
And in case they are, let's say, like, since we elected them to, you know, to present us.
Yes.
And they are not working.
Mm-hmm.
In case they are being arrested, and it's that they are guilty. Mm-hmm. They're supposed to be prosecuted. I don't see any problem with that. Yeah.
Mark Vichacha, your final thoughts on this?
Number one, this country has serious problems. Our debt is too high. Our county governments can't raise enough revenue. Our national government is trying to raise revenue to meet the Big Four agenda, and it's a difficult thing. We have to borrow again this year. Then for us to use time, intellect, space, per diem, transport, to discuss what is a legal impossibility and a moral injustice in this day and age is a waste of time. In fact, the people who have noticed their governors going to ask for immunity should now know that if elections come in 2022, fire that person, because their only concern is to be immunized so that they can be able to rape and pillage and plunder your county. That is their sole mandate. The truth of the matter is this social media gurus and socialites who are moonlighting as governors need to be kicked out, because there's nothing of substance they're bringing to these counties. They need to be telling us things like, for example, we've come to Nairobi to ask for the chance for us to be able to host the Blue Summit when it's held in Canada. That's what we want. We've come to Nairobi to ask Barack Obama, in as much as you're going to Nyanza, please visit us in Mombasa. Those are the kind of things that governors should be talking about. But when you find governors who will spend our tax money to go debate nonsense on the national stage, that is a governor who has no respect for the people who voted for him. He has no respect for himself. And number three, he has no respect for the constitution of this country. They should all resign.
Monarchy?
I think what we need to tell governors and what they need to have learned by now is, one, I invited them to read Article 49 of the Constitution. That is where the Constitution has given all Kenyans immunity in the name of bail and bond. If you steal and we catch up with you, we'll give you bail and bond. It is their right. That is the immunity extended to anybody. Secondly, listening to the COG chair, you get the feeling that we are running the counties like a choir, where it's only the choir master who can raise the voice and who can determine when the voice will go down. Mm-hmm. Without the choir master, things will go haywire. Look at it this way. If today a governor is not there, we have a deputy governor, we have CECs, what issue do we have? Nyeri governor for the longest, Nyeri county for the longest time did not have a governor. The county did not collapse. And all these other places, Governor Joho was going through the whole part of the world, visiting and touring, but Mombasa was still running. You could see Kingi receiving visitors. That is how leadership is. And leadership is not about your presence. It is about what we will see and do when you are gone. Yeah. You will have left systems that appreciate the prevailing circumstances. Finally, in terms of governors, it is a tragedy that we are having our governors coming to Nairobi to sit in a five-hour meeting to discuss immunity, while we have not seen them having a meeting to ask the president, where is my share of the big four? Mm. If today I was a governor, I will be asking, in my county, where is my share of the housing? I have people who are living in slums.
Yes.
Give me something. I have hospitals which are not well, do not have equipment. Give me something. I have youths who have not been employed. Bring one of the flagship projects of Big Four to my county. But what do? They come here, talk about immunity. They come here, tell us corruption has been politicized. By who? Maybe there are MCAs in their counties, but not from the national level.
All right, so the backlash continues over this proposal by the Council of Governors to have the county bosses be granted immunity from prosecution. Very quickly, Edgar Wangula says on Twitter, Kenyan leaders really are jokers. They have realized that things are getting hot. Now they are shaking because they are not clean governors. They should be ready to be axed. Maurice Mandela says it's regrettable that such utterances can come from an elected leader. There's one here from Eurobond analyst on Twitter says, that is about the SGR, and he gets one on this issue. Maurice Odor says, Omar Ahmed says, why immunity? Are they so special? No one is above the law. The laws of Kenya should be applied to all and not selectively. Keep the conversation ongoing on Twitter on our hashtag KTN Sunday Edition. Let's take another quick commercial break here on the broadcast. We come back, we wrap up the show this Sunday. We'll talk about the reshuffle of the cabinet by the President Uhuru Kenyatta and the subtle messages that have been ongoing. And what has been happening, what this latest reshuffle means. Don't go too far.
This is KTN News.